Our father, Silanthius, has already started his sermon. Just enter the temple and see the light of truth. We are a peaceful lot, so please...
The Lord of the Jesus, for he has fought those who reject the and temptation of and other sinful lures of the enemy. And those who want, he grants salvation, as he
lost hope. We're not from here either. Silanthius locked us up here a year ago. Yes, the bridge dwellers won't even talk to heretics. But I'll tell you everything I've seen in this place all that year. Oh, it's the bridge guard. Silanthius fooled them just like the locals. But unlike them, the bridge guard have guns. Run! There's a way out down here and there's a boat at the dock.
We also have one, but it's too small for all of us.
Artyom, she's right. Get to the boat. We will rescue her later. Don't worry.
Go! Nastya and I can get to your train by ourselves.
Mommy, mommy, hush, hold down to help you now. sermon.
And then what?
Well, he's there, and then he kind of disappears. And just like Father Silentius said, the man was sent by the devil.
Yeah, I know. I know what Father said. Tell me if you saw where he went.
Come out of the tent.
Sleepy.
Right there, on the ladder. Nobody should be there.
I know you can handle this just fine.
Tell me if you saw where he went.
Come out and don't show to this man anymore.
Artyom, I can't cover you when you're inside. I'm changing position to meet the woman and child. I know you can handle this just fine.
Satan himself.
And do you believe them?
Well, they say that as soon as Father Silentius finished his sermon, there was a flash of hellish light and the heretic just vanished.
Did they smell sulfur?
No, they didn't.
But they say that the satanic machine has a vat with sulfur and a vat with oil in it. And whoever gets seduced by the heretics gets oiled.
Have you seen the heretic system?
Women in oil, men in sulfur.
And you believe them?
So you
that
have
machine
seen?
Only has coal and water. All right, let's go look for him then.
Protect me.
So, did you see him or not? I don't get it.
What is it? Are you okay? What's that? Near the campfire.
Minion of evil!
find the heretic brothers. Let's get out of here.
Dad! They killed a brother!
Hey, Infidel! Where are you? That fish is growing tired of waiting for you!
Without bloodshed. They're bound to hate us even more now. Oh well. Artyom, Katya, and Nastya are with me now. See you aboard the Aurora. Check the map. Looks like you can row straight to it from there.
What the fuck was that? A whale? It's fucking huge!
The old man sent me out as a forward sentry. Told me that I was to sit tight and under no circumstances look for any action. So I just had a front row seat watching you there.
And so you subdue the occupation forces peacefully with a holy cross and a prayer. Anna has already reported on the call.
is Artyom, back from the abyss of NATO.
You're alive!
Occupation.
Impressive after the horrors Duke told us about. Let's go. Dad's talking to Katya right now. They are so nice, both Katya and her daughter. And Katya's medical training will come in handy.
Thank you for the information, Katya. But there is
this. In the meantime, we have dug in here. We have been waiting for the occupying forces, but so far we have only seen winged and four-legged ones.
Artyom, Miller here. I have a new task for you. Cut
by the way, Alyosha, my friend, that Katya lady Anna brought in? She's a nurse, so maybe you should have her look at your wound, huh?
Artyom, stop by my desk once you're done talking to the old man. I've got something for you. How do you like the backpack? Is it comfortable? Can you operate stealthily with it?
Damn. What do I even do about this?
I could replace the cylinder, but there's just no spare.
Thank you, Artyom. If not for you, we'd never have escaped that place. They were so busy looking for you. And then Anna picked us up.
We should have landed on that field. We were still flying, and it looked like we could have gone on for some time. And then that damn power line. But really, what difference does that make anyway? But I'm getting to Moscow from here, that's for sure. I don't really give a damn. I'm all alone with the others. Their relatives there. Maybe. It's been 10 years, but I could still be alive. Anyways. We'll have to make ourselves at home here now, since we're alive. The bridge seems like a nice place. At least it's not going to get flooded. We might end up going to Moscow by rail later. Well...